like and subscribe right now, or else this will be in your bed tonight. r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. What's the biggest lie you've heard about college? If you get hit by the campus bus, your tuition is paid for by the college. Sent from my wheelchair. I know a woman who had her foot run over by one of the maintenance carts at university. She sued them and was awarded $250,000. That more than paid for her tuition. Edit. Since people keep commenting about the legitimacy of her lawsuit and this got way more attention than I thought it would, here's the full story. The dude hit her with his maintenance cart and crushed her foot when she fell to the ground. He was drunk at work and completely negligent. She ended up in the hospital and needed expensive medical bills covered. The university denied all responsibility and refused to pay for her medical bills. Despite having liability insurance for that exact scenario, she was out time, money, pain and suffering, and missed a bunch of work and school. I think they got off easy. Fuck in hell. Wish my college had those cards. I'm going to that dude's campus. That it doesn't matter if you don't know what you want to study right away and you can switch your major at any time. While parts of this are true, college is expensive. I switched my major after my second year and had to take a fifth year to finish my degree. It's cheaper to take classes at a community college if you are unsure of what you want to study and then transition into university once you've decided. You don't pay thousands of dollars to find yourself. Also, if you go to a university where the majors are competitive, which was my experience, you have to somehow balance finding yourself TM while also being at risk of missing out on your chances at one of your potential majors if you fuck up on one of your prerequisite course exams. Hey now, a lot of people find themselves right after bombing their Calc 2 exams. Really coincidental like that. I mean, I'm sympathetic because there are an increasing number of kids being pushed into majors that require calculus just because they've been told those degrees guarantee them high-paying jobs. If they don't really have a desire to study that stuff but they're doing it because it seems like an obvious way to get a good job and maybe they, like, did well in at math in high school, I don't think it's fair to kinda mock them for finding themselves after they don't do well. In undergrad, I was one of those kids. Came in as a math CS double major, and I hated it. Calc 2 ruined me. 4 weeks in, I changed to political science and philosophy majors because I was absolutely miserable and doing terribly, and I found that I was doing better in my classes because I actually liked the material. Then, 3 years in, I had to take a methods course for my policy major, and I found that I actually enjoyed the math because I liked the context in which I was studying it, so I added a stats minor, which I loved because I had motivation to work through the math. After a complicated series of events that aren't worth going through here, I ended up adding a stats major, and I had to finish my calculus series over 5 years after taking Calc 1. And you know what? I killed it. I wasn't any better at math. I just wanted to be there. Now, I'm a grad student in statistics at a top 20 program. And I definitely wouldn't be anywhere close to here if I had pushed through instead of finding myself. Sex and drunk all the time. All I remember is paper deadlines. My experience was closer to the former, but the flame out was grand. Yet I definitely spend more time wobbly than I did sober and doing work. Wobbly sausage, a good time for all. My dad spent my entire senior high school year and my entire time in college telling me the same thing over and over. If you have a college degree, any job will hire you. Doesn't matter what kind of degree it is or what kind of job it is. They'll just hire you because you have a college degree. I don't think I really believed it, but I was too busy to question it anyway. The best part? When I got out of college and had trouble getting a job that didn't involve a cash register and customer service, he kept repeating it and claimed I just wasn't trying hard enough. Edit. For everyone that sound really freaked out, this was years ago and I have a job now. Used to be true. Times are different now. Trust me, I knew that even back then. But dad's always acted like we all live in a time warp and nothing ever changed and everything being different is just people being us. Things are better now. But back then, it didn't really help when the only advice I got from him was you're just not trying. My dad used to tell us to go out and shake the bushes. We would get so sick of hearing that. My parents graduated from college in 1970 and they literally had places lining up to give them a job. When I graduated from college in 1997, there was nothing. My parents just didn't get it. The two that stand out are professors would only accept papers written in cursive. And the only path to college is doing well in high school. The former isn't true because of these things called computers, and the latter isn't true because of this thing called community college. If you choose Greendale, you're already accepted. E. Pluribus anus. Greendale humans. Pop pop. Oh, there's a bunch that I heard across all three colleges I went at. All the dining hall food had laxatives in it, so you'll shit it out before you get food poisoning. If the professor is more than 15 minutes late, everyone can leave without getting in trouble. If your roommate dies, you get an automatic A every class. Every elevator and crosswalk has a secret code you can punch in to make it go faster. Every building is haunted. Most of that is totally false. Most professors respected the 15-minute rule at my college. Literally had a professor run into class 14 minutes late and yell, "I made it, everyone. Sucks to be you." College is weird. At my university, once passed the 100 level classes, I found it extremely rare for any of my professors to even care about attendance. We either showed up or we didn't. On the other hand, my upper level professors were a bit better about showing up on time too. Where I went, most of the profs and TA were like, "If you skip, not much I can do about it. If you walk out, oh well, that's on you." But I had one prof who spent maybe 10 minutes in a class of about 50 people taking attendance and marked that down for participation. A high school teacher told us that the summer before college is the last long vacation you'll have. The many years of college were actually the longest vacation I've had. Even considering strictly the official holidays, I've got like 6 months of vacation France. It will be hard when I will finally work. And then the lockdown happened. Yeah, my vacation before college truly will be my longest vacation ever. When I was in 7th grade, some of my cousins told me that colleges could look at your search history, and I believed them. I immediately went through all my search history, deleted it, and purposely searched up stuff like how to solve quadratics or what does I represent, so I could sound smart hardworking to colleges. That is hilarious. See, you misunderstood. They weren't talking about the College Board, but the National Scholarship Association, NSA for short. That the professors don't help you. This isn't universal. I had my share of profs that were sink or swim. But I found a majority were willing to go above and beyond for you if you put the effort in. If you're at a research university, some of your professors have made their life's work out of your class. If you show the interest in their work the same way they have, and show JT by sitting in the front and asking relevant questions, or greeting them with a hello and thank you before and after behind, when you go to their office for help, or copies of the slides because you missed class, because you sit in front they missed your face, they will give you a hand. I had a professor who taught municipal politics, Canada, and the course was largely about separation of powers. Federal, provincial, municipal, responsibilities. The guy was a super nerd about it, and as it turns out I was too. Really enjoyed the class, always sat in front. And when my girlfriend's mom passed away when a major paper was due, gave me all the time in the world to finish it. Someone passed away that was really no relation to me, and I basically handed the paper in after finals were over. 3 weeks late, no problem. Edit, I'm leaving it, you old ass. After behind, what kind of classes were you taking? Sign me up. As a prof can confirm so much of this. I very much appreciate the students who sit in the front, and who are consistently there, every single class. They show up to class early, they have written notes from the textbook prior to my lectures, participate in class discussions, and it's honestly a joy to teach them. That you'll meet the love of your life there. Or your lifelong best friends, lol. Are you telling me you didn't have a smiling multicultural group of friends either? Don't forget the one guy who's in a wheelchair. That smart and mature people go to college, no matter what college I attended, or what campus I visited, and regardless of their alma mater, there are a fair amount of fools on any campus and from any school, and an expected number of people still experiencing the growing pains of adulthood. This isn't to say they shouldn't be proud of their academic accomplishments or happy about their career prospects. Rather, it is simply that they are by all means deficient in areas I think one ought to not be deficient in. maturity, insightfulness, self-awareness, etc. Damn, you even spelled out etc. Where did you go to school? Anyone who fully spells out etc. is immediately awarded tenure at a school of their choosing. ETCETERA, I'll have one Hogwarts please. You'll get laid. SMH. Wait, as a matter of fact, the deadlines and professors did duck my head up. Shudder, so many awkward Tinder dates. You actually got matches on Tinder? It's definitely easier in college. People are free from parents and are experimenting. Especially in the first couple years when you're in the dorms and a hookup could literally be down the hall. You need to go to college in order to succeed in life. Different paths have different requirements. My best advice to anyone wondering if college is the move or not is to start by job hunting. Find the jobs you want, and list out what the requirements are. If it's a college degree, great. If it's not, pursue whatever else, trade school, certificates, etc. instead. My advice would be to look up careers in middle school or high school that you may be interested in and find out what's required to get there. I did this and figured out Army didn't require a HS diploma, so I got a GED. Went to recruiters and they told me only about 10-15% candidates without a HS diploma are accepted. Had to enroll into community college and get 15 credits, which took longer. I'd still talk to an adult about making any decisions. It's the best time of your life. I love being disoriented and depressed all the time. What are you talking about? I went from undergrad to PhD over an 18-year. Yeah, I was a little slow on the undergrad period and I loved college until the last 6 months of my PhD. It was the best time of my life. I understand how the environment has changed. I am now a prof, and I try to make my classes about learning instead of getting the grade. It should be a fun time. It sucks that competition has made it so mentally damaging, along with the debt that comes with many college experiences. If you can, make each course about learning the material, not about getting the A, so that you can go on to do the next project. Focus on the present if you can. Obviously that doesn't work all the time, but it helped me enjoy myself. I felt this way about high school too, but indeed it was the best time of my life. Discovered I was B and got friends with people that I'd not usually hang out with. The anxiety, depression and also the acceptance phase were harsh, but I can't deny that was a really important part of my life. When I was in 11th 12th grade, I had a handful of teachers spending unreasonably huge workloads of homework that were clearly valueless busy work. Their justification was that they were preparing us for the rigors of college, and if we found this workload unmanageable, we were doomed to flunk out of college. My first 2 years of college were significantly less rigorous than my last 2 years of high school. Those teachers should have been pushing personal accountability and self-discipline, not just stressing us out in the hopes that we develop appropriate coping mechanisms. Man, in high school, you'd go to your English teacher and ask if you could have a day extension because you have 6 AP exams. Your grandma died, and you have to start chemo, and they'd be like, welcome to college. Then you get to college and go to your professor and say, the paper is due on my birthday and I plan on getting trashed. Can I have an extra day? And they're like, take an extra week. Sounds like you'll have a hangover. I had a high school teacher knock off points on a test for signing my name in the wrong place on a piece of paper. He told me this is what I will have to deal with regularly in college. I graduate this year, and I have yet to see a college professor do anything like that. That the professors are going to be worse than the teachers at high school. I've already finished my first year of college and the professors have been extremely helpful. Even more helpful than my high school teachers. I've always hated writing essays in English, but my college professor has helped me a lot and gave me lots of helpful tips. When I turned in my first essay, he was amazed at it because I followed all of his instructions. I don't know why high school teachers implement fear to their students of how hard college is. Instead, I would have liked it better if they actually teaches us the subject instead of hearing their past life and how they ended up as a teacher. Professors are usually also researchers who are passionate about their work, so helping out students is something they love to do. Not saying that high school teachers of the subject are not passionate, but college professors are on another level in the field. You'll get a job if you have a degree. Not gonna lie, it's nice to have literally no stress from that as someone in nursing. Instead, you just have one of the most stressful jobs on the planet. join our community Discord, link in description. That there's this sudden massive difficulty hike as soon as you get there. As someone who never really learned how to study in high school, the difficulty spike was real for me. But I get if you went to a high school that prioritized self-lead education, and I am envious of that. Can confirm. Never had to study in high school. A's with no effort. Got to college. First year was a huge shock. 2.2 after my first year. Spent the next 3 years salvaging my GPA back to a 3.0 by graduation. Pharmacy school was way easier, though, since I finally knew how to study. I've actually seen this happen. Two people, equally smart. One goes to a suburban school. One goes to a country school. The school in the suburb offers advanced courses, guidance counseling, and top teachers who will help you keep up. A school in the country might not have any of that. Two people, equally smart. The one from the suburb thought the first year was a breeze. The one from the country was working her butt off to keep up. Both ended up graduating with good marks in engineering. The lie is given by one of my old high school teachers. College is extremely difficult. For every hour of class time you will need to study at least another hour if you want to get even a C grade. As the homework is also hard because every assignment is like a final project and you'll spend hours on each one. My experience. College is just more of the same in regards to high school. You may struggle a bit with new subjects. But, not in any way you don't struggle with the subject now. The homework is a bit more detailed. It is not final project quality though. Otherwise his advice is true for STEM majors. I was about to say, I was a near straight A student in high school but when I got to college for CS, the first 3 semesters kicked my behind because school has always come easy to me and I never learned how to study properly. I'm just now learning to get my shit together and put in the work necessary to pass my classes, let alone get good grades. But I'm getting there. LOL. That everyone will come to the diving competition to cheer for you when you perform the triple Lindy. To those who have been through college, how much would you say prestige and rankings matter? They definitely help to get into certain jobs at certain companies. For instance, if you really want to go to Wall Street or go to a top consulting company, the vast majority of hires come from top schools. The way I've always thought about it is that if you have 2 exactly equal candidates but one went to Harvard and the other went to a community college, which one are you going to pick? If the job weren't very prestigious, I might take the community college guy because I'd think the Harvard guy would get a better opportunity and abandon the job. You got that right. Except that if the Harvard graduate is looking for work at a chip stand, it's because there's just no work. An exaggeration. I know. I went to college and could not find work in my field. I went to other places and could not get hired because you'll just FK off in a few weeks. You have to go to college so you can get a good job. Well, what is a good job? What if I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life? I don't particularly love my current job that has nothing to do with my degree. BTW. But you know what? I still have one. I can support myself and live fairly comfortably. All my degree did was put me in debt. You'll find your soulmate there. I found a soulmate at least. The expensive ones are better. I have degrees from state schools and Ivy League schools. The state school was flat out better and cheaper. You can get just as good a degree, maybe better, from a reasonably priced school and not go thousands into debt. To add to this, I went to a community college and then transferred to a highly ranked university, and I actually found my classes at the community college were much better. I think that going to a school based on cost or ranking can actually backfire on people because I think that at higher ranked schools professors can be much more focused on research rather than teaching. Current college student here. The biggest lie I've heard is probably one of the following. Comma, you're at an elite school. Everyone is going to be brilliant. Absolutely not true by any stretch of the imagination. There was a guy who drunkenly drove his motorcycle into a tree because he thought it would be funny. Comma, it's a massive place. There's no one culture that defines it. While OFC there will be things for people with different interests. As there are 8,000 students there, the university's general culture related stereotypes fit remarkably well. Comma, it's not like high school. There are no popular kids. At least at my school. Top tier fraternities and sororities effectively function as the popular group. Comma, it's going to be an intellectually driven experience. If I had a dollar for every kid who was taking honors multilingual ALG because it looks good for BB recruiting, I'd have the funds to pay for a plane ticket to Hong Kong. People are very pre-professional. Perhaps for a reason. Not at all true. College has been enormously humbling in this way. There are students who come in with a weak foundation and soak it up like a sponge. And most famously, comma, college will be the best 4 years of your life. For some people it will, but for most people it won't. You might want to pick somewhere other than Hong Kong right now. It's hard and you don't have enough time. When people just don't prioritize it and want to have a life, like going to college isn't a life already. I have a wife and 2 kids. 3 years of college. And never did I have the issues the others did. Was way more than enough time. Work was decent if you took the time to study. I kept hearing no time. Then realized people want to drink, party, play video games and anything more than work. I rather work now and play later with more money. Play time as a poor bum sucks. OHH. That's relieving. The general consensus is that college is a mammoth's task. You certainly can make it one. Many students sign up for 18 or more credit hours and cram as much actual class time into their schedule as they can. And then there's no time left for all the reading and other homework that's meant to happen outside of class. So then they skip the reading and figure that's okay because everyone does it because nobody has the time, and then they get crap grades while feeling like they're working so hard. You get the idea. As someone who stuck to 12-15 credit hours and did the reading and other homework, it's definitely possible to do well, gain an education, and enjoy a life all at the same time. I think I'd cap a 12 if I was working more than 20 hours a week though. That the friends you make there will be lifelong. I learned that you make a lot more acquaintances than friends in college. Thinking back, it's weird and funny how I would be group partners, lab partners with someone I was randomly paired up with, work with them 4 weeks and even exchange phone numbers, emails. A year can go by and you see them by the quad and they don't even acknowledge you. This current college student, and this couldn't feel more true. It's a bizarre experience. The separation between classmate and friend prevails even on such a small campus. This, in my experience, the friends I made there were friends just for the time being. A lot of the friends you make in college are out of convenience. You live on the same floor, have been planning to work together in a group, etc. Once it's not convenient anymore, the friendship dies. That being said, I loved all the friends I made in college. Even if we don't see each other anymore, they played a part in a great period of my life. It's fun. I feel this. I did the semester at uni and moved back home and am currently doing online college. Absolutely hated that time on campus. That you will somehow become Bill Gates if you drop out. As others before me have pointed out, Gates, and Mark Zuckerberg, for that matter, dropped out of Harvard, so they had to have been good enough to get accepted. That the lecturers, tutors don't care about you or your grades. The professors will be hard brains and you'll meet your best friend in college. Many people told me that living in a student hostel is better than to rent a room or flat because it's all fun and stuff, but I experienced both, and for me a separate room all to myself was infinitely better. Growing up in the South, it's nothing but libtards and their safe spaces. Literally nobody cares what you politically, religiously, whatever identify as. On a campus with thousands of people, there's too many different things going on to care. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.